Hi everyone. Welcome to my channel where I share tips and tricks on how to use Photoshop. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to use the new Generative Fill feature powered by Adobe Firefly Generative A. This feature allows you to add, extend, or remove content from your images using simple text prompts. It's amazing what you can do with this ES feature. So let's get started. First, you need to install the Photoshop Beta app on your desktop, which you can find in the Beta Apps tab of your Creative Cloud desktop app. This is where you can access the Generative Fill feature and also give feedback to Adobe on how to improve it. I have already installed, so it is showing an open button. Once you have installed the Photoshop Beta app, open it and create a new document or open an existing image. Next, you need to make a selection of the area where you want to use Generative Fill. You can use any selection tool in Photoshop, such as the Lasso tool, the Quick Selection tool, or the Magic Wand tool. For example, I have this image of a woman in car, and I want to add shoes to make it more logical. I'm going to use the Lasso tool to draw a rough selection around the area where I want the shoes to appear. Now, you need to click on the Generative Fill button in the contextual taskbar that appears when you make a selection. You can also find it in the Edit menu or by right, clicking on the selection. This will open a text entry prompt box where you can type what you want to generate in your image. You can use natural language to describe what you want, such as shoes, a castle, or a dog. You can also leave it blank if you want Photoshop to generate something based on the context of your image. For this example, I'm going to type shoes and hit enter. Photoshop will then use Adobe Firefly Generative AI to create shoes in my selection and blend them with the rest of the image. You can see that it adds realistic shadows, reflections, lighting, and perspective to make it look natural. It also generates the content on a new layer so you can edit, refine, or remove it without affecting the original image. You can also use Generative Fill to extend your images, remove unwanted objects, or create images from scratch. For example, if I want to extend this image horizontally, I can use the Crop tool to increase the canvas size and then use Generative Fill on the empty area without typing anything. Photoshop will then generate a harmonious extension of my scene. If I want to remove an object from my image, such as this boat, I can use Generative Fill on it without typing anything. Photoshop will then make it disappear and fill in the gap with matching content. If I want to create an image from scratch, I can use Generative Fill on a blank document and type something like a fantasy landscape. Photoshop will then generate a stunning image based on my prompt. As you can see, Generative Fill is a powerful and versatile feature that can help you create amazing images in seconds. You can experiment with different prompts and ideas and see what Photoshop comes up with. You can also fine-tune your results using other editing tools in Photoshop. Change eye colors. Open the image in Photoshop. Next, you need to select the eyes using the selection tool. Type blue color on Generative Fill in contextual bar. Finally, you need to use the Generative AI Fill feature in Photoshop to blend the color layer with your original image. But in the rough selection, it changes the face shape. To do more realistic selection tool and select only both eyes, go to the Select menu and expand that selection and repeat the same steps, the results are better. To create it more realistic, select only that part of both eyes that you want to change with elliptical tool and type blue color on Generative Fill in contextual bar. The results are more realistic now. And that's it. You have successfully changed your eye color by using Generative AI Fill in Photoshop. Soft skin. Certainly, here's a short explanation on how to use Generative Fill in Photoshop to achieve soft skin. Open an image duplicate a layer by using Ctrl-J in Windows or Command. In Mac, click on Quick Mask button from Toolbar. After that, go to the Edit menu. Then select Fill and select Color. Add 30 Zan B box click out. Then again, select the Quick Mask button. Generative Fill be active. I'm going to type Skin Smoothing and Skin Toning and hit Enter. Photoshop will then use Adobe Firefly Generative AI to create smooth skin and selection and blend them with the rest of the image. You can see that it adds softness toning. I'm selecting the most closet option given by AE Fill. It also generates the content on a new layer, so you can edit, refine, or remove it without affecting the original image. So I am selecting the mask and going to Image menu, then select Apply Image, the blend image with original. It opens with default settings. You can go with it and click OK. A new mask will be created. Now you can show those areas that you don't want to smooth. So I'm painting on the mask with black brush over hair, eyes, lips, and tip of nose. So shape of the face will not be changed. To look more realistic, I have clicked twice on layer to open a blending option. Move the current layer slider to left to more refined result. Hold Alt click in Windows or hold Alt click in Windows or hold Option. Click on Mac to split the slider button and make adjustments according to your requirements. Now it looks realistic. Change background. Another useful feature I have experienced with Generative Fill that is change background. So I open a new image on Photoshop and duplicate a layer by using Ctrl-J in Win or Command-T-J in Mac. Click on Select Subject from contextual bar after selection. You can go to Select and Mask option on top option bar. Take care before selecting Select a Mask. Your selection tool should be active. Any selection tool, so you can see this option. I open this because I need to refine hair in selection. First, I invert the selection, then select a Refine Edge brush from toolbar and paint over the hair. Those are not selected. After that, I select the option New Layer Mask. Click OK. Now selection was made, and I click on the mask to activate a selection. I'm going to type Change Texture Background and hit Enter. Photoshop will then use Adobe Firefly Generative AI to create few options of texture background in my selection and blend them with the rest of the image. You can see that it adds realistic shadows, reflections, lighting, and perspective to make it look natural. It also generates the content on a new layer so you can edit, refine, or remove it without affecting the original image. I like the fourth option from the options given by AI Fill. If you don't like anyone, you can repeat the same step. So second time, it gives me another four option. And finally, I selected this one. It looks unique and realistic, and shadows and lighting look more natural. The use of Generative Fill is endless. It is up to you, how can you use it? I hope you enjoyed this vlog and learned something new about Generative Fill powered by Adobe Firefly Generative 8. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more Photoshop tutorials. Also, don't forget to check out the Photoshop beta app and share your feedback with Adobe on how to improve this feature. Thanks for watching and see you next time.